along with, and even in our group, we do actually study on the energetic compatibility between mixtures of phospholipids. So we are looking into binary mixtures of interaction between two lipids. Because as a polymer chemist, I know that none of the material can be mixed. Even very simple, if you are doing polymers, you have PP and PE. PP and PE, they don't mix. If you are working in metal alloy. Yeah, Simone, you are working and mix two metal, for instance. So two metal, you look at alloy, for instance. Two metal, they don't mix because they have problem with interface with two metal. Visually, they are maybe homogeneously mixed as a material, but if you look at closely, they actually don't mix. Right? Similarly, with all this material, lipids, phospholipid, fatty acids, right? Cholesterol, proteins, they are not easily mixed. There's always energy that actually prevents this compound, this lipid from homogeneity. So we do study on it. At the same time, since we are actually looking into interaction between molecules, we look into interaction between this bilayer with the protein, because you can put maybe antibody in the laboratory. You can specifically targeting the site that you're interested, so you can have specific targeting. So we're looking at interaction between proteins and bilayer, in bilayer. At the same time, we also look into drug interaction in the membrane itself, because if you put drugs in the membrane, not necessarily the drug is there. You have to understand what type of drug you put in. So you have to understand what molecule actually you are studying as well, right? Whether it likes water, it likes lipids, it likes oil, it likes partially water and oil, right? Because if you look at this a simple cartoon illustration of bilayer lipid, you can have some of the drug actually in the center of the lipid. You can actually have the drug actually positioned in the lipid by itself, right? This is hydrophobic, okay? You may, just like some protein, right? It's always stays along this. So you have integral protein over here, so you have some drug actually stays in the place in between the head groups of the lipid and the hydrophobic layers. So this is what we are studying in detail. So I'm not going to talk about that. I'm just telling you what is the applications from a simple membrane study that we're working on. Right. So now I actually touched a bit on encapsulation. Now, the protections, basically some of the material, if you expose to aqueous, right, some of drugs, or even lipid, you expose lipid to water, after some time it becomes hydrolyzed. So you lose, you become like fatty acid, and you have some glycerol, okay, you lose all this. Right? Very simple, you take, now we are working with one of the industry, been sometimes exporting, selling tocotrienol, for instance. Tocotrienol is like vitamin E. We also have Indian conglomerates incorporation from New York actually would like us to work on cannabidiol. Cannabidiol is extract from cannabis, right? Cannabis. So the drug actually hydrophobic. So we tell them, when we look at the structure of the drug, we know that we can encapsulate 100% of the drug into the liposome. Right? Now, looking at this, even the protein itself, you see, you notice some of the protein is partially, if you look at this transmembrane protein, because this one, you can see much clearer, okay? This part of the protein, basically protein is protein, but, you know, why this protein actually sit across and part of the protein actually over here and part actually down there, because those part of the protein amino acid actually exposed to water. They prefer to be in water. Those doesn't like the water actually stays in it. Right? So this is where interests us. So we're talking about antibody, for instance. So it's just like maybe integral protein. So partially in the membrane, partially outside. So you can use it in targeted drug delivery liposome. Now, just quickly, as I said, I like to talk, right, to make sure that I'm on time. So, liposome, you can actually have different type of liposome. You can have very small one, right? You have nano size, less than 100 nanometer, less than 100 nanometer. But if you are talking about intravenous liposome, we are talking about maybe greater than 50 nanometers. And you have a large and very large one. Basically, you can form valley that fit the size of your container. Right? You can form valley the size of it. That's how. You can control it to as small as possible. But just like our cell, you cannot control it. Right? You cannot, it grows, isn't it? It grows. Right, over time. However, if you want it, you want to use it for technological purposes, like as a drug delivery, you have to make sure that the size of the liposome you prepare, you synthesize, you design. So I call it design. Right? I don't call it you synthesize. People say, why you say design? Because you have to make sure that if you're designing a house, what kind of house you like to have? You want to have veranda maybe, you have to have a big yard maybe, you have a hall, you have a kitchen, and each functions on its own. That's why I say we design. Right? We just design. Even how much composition to put in, we have to make it precisely, energetically, actually suitable for these two molecules to be mixed at that composition. You don't have to be thing, no. Right? If you don't know, you just use differently, you just make different concentration. But we can do through energetic approach such that we can pinpoint how much more ratio we have to add in. One pinpoint. By through energetic. Right? Binary mixing kind of approach. So we can do that. Right? And oligomers, this is when you have the liposome inside the liposome. Liposome inside the liposome. Right? This is very important because recently I just got a call, one of our, we call it LRGS, which is where to apply this grant in collaboration with industry. So we are using Retromed 1 protein. Retromed 1 protein. This is for internal for general applications, right? There are many applications. Now we can actually put the liposome inside the liposome so that we have with just one bilayer, one membrane, right? It may be destroyed, right? And whatever load inside it release. But if you have many membranes, many bilayer membranes, so you have liposome inside the liposome. So one definitely virtually will be destroyed because inside the pH, right, you can change whether you can get pregnant or not pregnant by changing the pH.